me. I ain't even got a phone. How are you supposed to text me?
I ain't even got a phone. How am I supposed to know this bitch is at the airport? Nigga, for 3 whole days, I be sitting there in my room stressing out. Like, what if this plane crashes? Because, you know, I was still traumatic about 9/11. I mean, even though I knew at that point that it was a hoax, but I was still like, God, fuck, just knowing that that could happen to me. I don't want this plane to go down. I don't want this plane to go down. I know I talk
Until
about
being someone that smoke.
I know I talk about suicide, but I don't no more because I see what it does to your family. It kills them all. When my uncle died, man, that was the hardest shit. We weren't the closest, but then you was the trailest bitch. I was at work. I told my boss she'll give me 5 minutes. She told me no. Get your ass back to work. You just took a cigarette break. You're lucky you're only 17. I wouldn't even let you take a cigarette break. You're not even old enough to smoke. The only reason why I'm letting you smoke because you know my son Robbie. Because you see, Robbie, the nigga that I actually, I'm gonna stop singing for a second. when I went with Tyler that first night, I actually blew up on Tyler. Because you know how like you and me never like fought, but like we'll like have disagreements.
Oh, yeah,
I don't got any. But fucking Tyler thought the only reason I didn't want to hang out with him that day that we were busy was because he didn't have any weed.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm trying to explain to him like, yo, like listen, like I get it, I'm 17, I like to smoke weed, every time you go out like that, chill, you don't even have to say something, I'm out there. But I'm like, yo, like, yeah, I'm 17, but you even said at the garage, you don't look at me like a kid no more, like, you look at me as an adult, I'm like, nigga, please look at this like an adult. I said, it's like you going to work. I said, yo, if I could spend every fucking day with you, Caleb, and my boys, just us doing our shit, I said, I'd love that. But I said, yo, bro, that's in a perfect world. I said, look around. I said, look at both of our lives. None of us had a perfect world. I was like, yo, if you want, I can come up another time. Like, and I was like, oh, but Saturday I'm going up to the beach.
You kill?
What?
Drop me. I want.
Oh,
my God. Oh, my God.
Oh, word.
It's like a, I know kind of.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because it fucks you up sometimes. Sometimes it fucks me up even when they are kings. I don't think that they are. But I was like, yo, like, look at this from, like, an adult perspective. Like, I get it. You want to chill. I get it that you drove down to Bowman's Town and, like, before, like, if maybe before I went to Kids Peace and shit really started to kick up and I really started to get into drugs and shit, yeah. And you and me really started to have fun and do shit.
I never, really did.
Yeah. But if
I didn't have the opportunity.
Yeah, if he would have hit me up anytime then, dude, that was back when we were just sitting in your room. But now it's like, I got niggas that I gotta take care of. I got a life that I gotta live, and I tried telling him that. I was like, yo, like, I know it kills me down inside. I wanna.
You just like, be like, yo, like, nothing's gonna affect, like,
yeah.
Like, this ain't about weed. We can never smoke weed ever again.
Yeah, I even told him, I'm like, yo,
you
like,
can't,
listen.
Can you?
No. Just put one black one on. Actually, if you can, yeah, can you
take
that?
Oh, shit, there's, like, a lot of things.
Yeah, I was like, yo, like, look at it this way, like, I'm busy. Look, I was like, yo, can I ask you a question? He goes, what? I said, what did you do at 17? He's like, I went out partying, I had a part-time job. I'm like, what am I doing? He goes, I guess you're doing the same thing that me. And he goes, but yo, I don't want you to wind up with me. He goes, did you see how much struggle it took for me to get to where I am now? He goes, I want you to be able to graduate high school. Yeah, I want you to be able to graduate high school and be able to be like, yo, Tyler, I'm making
real life.
Yeah, I'm making just as much as you, if not more than you. And I'm not.
And not
I'm
in a business way.
Yeah. He told me, he goes, that is the thing I'm waiting for. He goes, I'm waiting for you to come to me with money and say, Tyler, I fucking need it. And he goes, you want to know what? If you even try to give me an ounce of that, I said, I will not take it. And I was like, yo, you know that if I start to make it in life, I got an extra $100, $200 in my pocket. I'm giving you some, bro. You gave me roof over my head for who knows how long. You gave me, that nigga's giving me so much life advice.
Yeah.
Oh, I set myself up. If it wasn't for him, I would have dropped out of school already. He's the one who made me stay in school.
I did not.
Because he was.